With our Nissan SR20 VE engine swap into our 350Z race car, one of the considerations was an inlet manifold or plenum chamber that was going to suit the rear-wheel drive application. With the stock P11 Primera cylinder head, this only comes out in a front-wheel drive application, and hence the factory plenum chamber wasn't going to work for our rear-wheel drive application. On top of this, however, we also knew that we're going to be flowing a lot more air than the stock P11 Primera inlet manifold was ever designed for. This required a bit of a rethink, and we're here at Plazmaman to find out exactly how our new inlet manifold was made. The design process starts with making sure that the base plate of the inlet manifold is going to perfectly match the bolt pattern as well as the inlet port profile of the P11 cylinder head. Once this has been confirmed, everything can be designed in AutoCAD's Inventor software. This allows a huge amount of freedom in manipulating the design, and for example, in our case, we've requested a plenum chamber with twin injectors per inlet runner. This is really easy for the team at Plazmaman to incorporate and modify their base model. A common question that comes up when discussing plenum chamber design is the length of the inlet runners. And we don't have the ability to get too in depth here, but there is a lot that goes into this. Of course, like a lot with motorsport, it comes down to a compromise. In general, a longer inlet runner tends to favour low RPM torque, while a shorter runner favours high RPM performance. Of course, we also need to factor in what can physically be fitted inside the engine bay and how that may or may not compromise the volume of the plenum chamber itself. So there's a lot to take in there. Before the design is finalised, it is run through a CFD or computational fluid dynamics software package to ensure that the flow and the design of the plenum and runners is optimised for the particular application and the expected power output. Once everything's finalised, tool paths are then created using Mastercam software. And these are the actual paths that the cutting equipment or cutting tools will make in the Haas 4-axis CNC machines. From here, the raw block of aluminium billet is placed in the CNC machine and the machining process can start. Now, the raw block of aluminium that Plazmaman start with weighs in the region of 35 kilograms. After around 7 hours in the CNC mill, the finished product ends up weighing only 4 kgs. So you can understand there is a huge amount of material that needs to be removed in the process of machining one of these manifolds. Once the machining of the manifold base is complete, we can look at the other components that go into the completed inlet manifold. These include the two halves of the plenum chamber. Now, these are formed out of high strength sheet aluminium that's 3 millimeters thick. Plazmaman also go to a lot of trouble to ensure that the entire plenum chamber retains that full 3 millimeters of thickness to make sure that maximum strength is retained. These are then welded together, and despite the look of those welds, I can assure you that they aren't completed by a robot. These are hand welded and the finish is amazing. With the plenum halves completed, they can then be welded onto that base of the manifold that's already been machined. With the body of the plenum welded to the base, the product is nearing completion. The last step really is adapting a throttle body onto the front of the plenum chamber. And this is where Plazmaman have the ability to use a variety of different flanges to suit a variety of different throttle bodies. These can include the CNC machined throttle bodies that Plazmaman make in-house, or you can adapt a range of off-the-shelf drive-by-wire throttle bodies, which is exactly what we're doing. We're using a Bosch Motorsport 74mm drive-by-wire throttle body, and one of the advantages with using a drive-by-wire throttle is it does also allow idle speed control to function through the throttle body. There are a couple of other finishing touches we'll discuss here. On the underside of the plenum is a flange that gets welded on, and this has a range of ports on it, allowing us to fit takeoffs for manifold pressure, for our map sensor, for our fuel pressure regulator, and any other sensors we may like to fit, such as an inlet air temperature sensor. Of course, we are also using a Plazmaman billet CNC machine fuel rail, and this is set up for our dual fuel injectors per inlet runner. Lastly, we'll discuss the options when it comes to adapting that drive-by-wire throttle body out to the rest of our intercooler plumbing. Now, conventionally, the Bosch drive-by-wire throttle body is set up for a silicone joiner. However, these have proven to be a little bit unreliable, particularly under high boost operation. Instead, we've chosen to use a Tux CNC machined adapter that allows us to now use the Plazmaman plasma clamps. Now, these ensure that once they're done up, there is absolutely no chance of those clamps coming undone. This ensures reliability out in the heat of competition. With our specific manifold now only requiring the throttle body adapter to be welded on, we're really excited to get it back to New Zealand and fit it up to our 350Z.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.